I'm going to show you how to make a TF2 server for free, no extra plugins, no port forwarding, nothing like that. So first, there's a command that I put in the description. If you want to copy it, go to the settings in TF2, properties, you want to paste it in launch options. This basically gives a fake IP to Steam, and I believe this helps for security sync when you're hosting your server, and then you launch TF2. Once you're in TF2, you're going to need Dev Console. If you don't have that enabled, you go to Options, Keyboard, Advanced, and Enable Dev Console. You want to make a rest check, OK, Apply, OK. Now go to Find the Game, Create Server. You can also open a Dev Console and just do map, whatever, but I prefer doing this. You want to select the map with a double cross. Max players is the max amount of slots you can have in one server. This includes bots, so I always leave it at 100. But if you're not going to play with bots, just do 5 or however many people are going to play with, and you do start. You're on your way to double cross. Your team stuff doesn't matter. You don't have item servers. You want to open the Dev Console by hitting the tilde key. SV cheats 1. That allows you to do commands and whatnot. SV LAN barrel. Now you have to restart the server. You do not want to leave the server yet. Make sure you're still in it, because otherwise the server will shut down. You have to do this again. Go to command and do map, whatever map you want. If you want capture the flag, you do CTL. And then you can hit tab to cycle through the options. CP for control point, PL payload. I'll leave a link to a list of all the TF2 map names if you want to find them. For now, we're just going to go back to CTF, double cross, going to hit enter. It seemed like nothing happened. You just have to wait. The game will freeze, won't be able to do anything. Just let it load. Now, as you can see, I have all my stuff. I have all my things. All my stuff. And now your friends can join. To have your friends join, you need to go to a dev console and look until you find fake IP allocation succeeded. You want to copy that, hit Control V, and then you want to delete the stuff that's fake, okay, just keep the numbers, type connect, and then you can send this to your friends. Your friends will copy this, and then they will paste it into their dev console in TF2 to be able to join. So now I send it to Alex, and he can just copy this, go to TF2, go into a dev console, paste it, and he will join. Hey, you see? Alex is in. It's Alex. Actually, this is my little brother playing in his account. Never mind. Come here. If you want people to not get kicked for being auto, you do MP idle message 0 and MP idle max 0. And now no one will get kicked for being auto. After making your server, you may notice that people will randomly join. That's because it's considered public, so people can come across it. If you don't want it to be public, you want it to be private, you do the command hide server 1, and now random people won't join. Next, I'm going to cover respawn times, TF2 bots, and some random other fun commands that you can use to mess with your friends and do whatever. Respawn time. We don't want respawn time, but bored. You do MP respawn wave time 0, and you respawn instantly. Also, preferably, you can do MP disable respawn times 1. That works better than respawn waves. Now, bots. One thing to note, there's only a few maps officially that have actual nav meshes. So most maps, your bots won't move unless you have a mod. I will link the mod in the description. The link will send you to this guide, Improved Navigation Mesh, and it supports a ton of maps. There's a ton of things you can do. What you want to do, at the top, you want to click this. Click Improved Navigation Mesh. Now, go back to your Steam. Click Manage Browser Files. You want to go to TF2 Custom. Now go to Download. Take the VPK you just downloaded. You drag and drop into this. Restart your game. Do the server setup stuff again, which seems like a lot, but really is not that bad. It's just a couple steps. Once you memorize, it's really easy. And you can always just bring up this video. It'll only be a few minutes. To turn off auto balance, you do MP auto balance 0 and MP teams unbalance limit 0. And now there's no auto balance. You can go to any game. This is important for bots. Normally, if you try and add a bot, they just start kill binding in the spawn rooms. That's because of a command TF bot re-evaluate class in spawn room, set them to 0. And finally, if you want bots to keep their class after they die, TF bot keep class after death 1. To add bots, you do TF bot add, you do a number, I'll do 10, and then the class, where you do either scout, soldier, pyro, Demoman heavy weapons. You have to type heavy weapons or Demoman to spawn demos on heavies, engineer, medic, sniper, and spy. And if you want it to be random, just ignore that. And then you do team, red or blue. If you want it to be random teams, leave that blank. And now we have 10 random classes of random teams. There you go. And because of the Napmas mod, they actually work, they actually run around. Normally they don't work on these maps. They do heal, bot, kick, all. You get rid of them. So now you can go into TF2 server with your friend for free, and you can fight Boston if you want. See, look at all those scouts. Now, we're gonna go into some fun commands. If you do add con and then a number, you can get a lot of effects. Add con 56 gives you infinite crit. Add con 51 makes you invulnerable. It's kind of like the MVM invincibility, where if you take any damage, only then will other people see this effect. If you want to refill your ammo and health at any time, you do impulse 101. So let's say I use up all my ammo, come here, spy, and I want to get it back. Impulse 101, and you have it back. And if you do add con 74, you become a giant guy with a bunch of health. To go back into first person, you do first person, and to go into third person, you do third person. Something me and my friend like to do, go something like heavy, go add con 74 so we're a giant, first person, and then add con 56 for crit, and it's basically like a boss battle. Oh, and to noclip, you do noclip me, and there you go. Let's say you're on a workshop and you find a cool map you want to use. You want to go to your TF2 thing, go to manage, browse local fires, keep note of this, go back to common, do not, go to workshop, content, over there is TF2, and you want to go through every folder until you find the map you're looking for. In this case, we're looking for Restless Polo. Go back to state maps, common, scroll down to Team Fortress 2, TF, maps, and you paste the custom map in here. That's how you can get the custom workshop maps. Your friends will unfortunately have to do the same thing to join your server. You would have to use a separate program or something if you want people to automatically download the map when they go in. But if you're doing it like this, no port forwarding, completely bare, all that stuff, you're gonna have to do it this way, unfortunately. Make sure you restart your game when you do anything to buy, by the way. And everything else is the same. Find, create server. Only difference is that you're gonna do a different map, and then you just do the same thing. Get the fake IP, send it to your friends, all that jazz. So yeah, that's how you can play with your friends, and that's how you do it. There you go. It's easy. Many things to say, oh, you need to port forward, you need to do this and that. You really don't. You can just do all this. Lots of thanks to a guide I'll put in the description. That's really how I figured out how to do all this, along with just messing around and videos. I'll link all the videos and stuff I got information from. And yeah.